Everything I said is stolen. My words have been reduced to a finite variety of slugs that have bribed themselves in every way possible, and have nothing left to do but repeat their pathetic squirmings until they die. There can be no new complete sentences. Can't be true. I'll use my pen. Yes, I'll work on my note. Let's see. Let's find the supplies here. The narrator is an old decrepit man. So how does it begin? Let's see.
They speak to me of words, but this thing has nothing to do with words. It is a question of the mind's duration. I represent the destiny that elects me. There is no such thing as human activity or existence. These are examples of this monotonous crucifixion. This crucifixion wherein the soul is forever lost.
Shoot myself? I do. you feel slack anymore, Dad. Now, it's the door. Visitor, bill collector, Martinez, an enemy, whoever it is, come in.
The king searched this land
and not laughed over. But instead of a princess double bowl but bride, he only found entitlement and more promises of doom for his friendly and peaceful kingdom. He returned with 500 armies trailing him in the far distance. He had not but woeful news for his over-equipped son.
Father, father, you did no find no bride for me. Find no bride.
No, there's no bride. Sorry, not in this land or in either.
Oh no, oh my long need forever and ever, cause there is no girl for me. Oh, father, this is a wound that will never dry. You think you're not?
Well, hardly. Did start several wars.
Wars? Oh, father.
Surgical tools,
the rock and roll demeanor.
You're hastily conceived, puppet, and by the looks of it, as hastily felt. I mean, look at your pathetic mop.
Oh, man, no, don't talk about it, man. Just shut up about the mop head, man. Come on, man.
Mop head?
No!
Mop head?
No, stop it, man!
Mop head! No. Everybody, call him mop head with me. Mop head! Canine world, but Something has snatched a hold of the dog's hind leg. It's a trap the woodsman has laid out for the bears. One of those steel traps with symmetrical steel sharp teeth from which escape is impossible. The dog whimpers and pulls, but to no avail. In a fit of hysterical desperation, the dog begins to chew away at the base of his hind leg, ignoring the pain in hope of any freedom. Finally, the dog chews directly through its own flesh and blood, both liberating and mortally wounding itself. In a spasm of remorse and terror, the dog rips its dismembered leg from the steel trap and clenches the trembling leg in its trembling jaws. The dog stands there, waving on three legs, a steady stream of blood flowing from the wound, like creating a liquid fourth leg. The dog thinks to himself.
I'm just a dog with a mouth. I'm just a dog with a mouth.
A pool of his own blood spreads under him. He looks down in the pool of blood and sees his own reflection. He sees just a dog with a mouth.
Here, that's me. I'm just a dog with a mouth. Just a dog with a mouth. I'm not dying.
Yeah. Stay put. Watch the stairs.